Good morning, everyone, and good week. We'll learn a maimer Vaikach Korach. It's a maimer that was said in Shabbos Mevorchim, like this Shabbos, Chodesh Tammuz, the month of Tammuz, so Monday, Tuesday, Chodesh. So Vaikach Korach. So the pasuk itself starts with a question. What does it mean he took? What did he take?
He took him aside, it said.
He took what? So Pirush Rashi interprets because of the difficulty to understand what did he took. It says, he took, Vayikach, Rashi says, Lokach es atzme letzad echo.
He was trying to calm him down.
No. Lies nechlak mitoch haidol leir alakun. So he took aside, that's when Vayikach Rashi says, he took himself to one side to be in machlekes. Lios nechlak is to be different from the community, mitoch haido, leir alakun, to question the kahuna. Okay, so he questions the kahuna of Aaron. Because we know that Korach wanted to be a Kohen Gadol, he wanted to be the high priest. So he questions, it's like someone wants to be a president. He questions the abilities of the president. He says, oh, he's not a good president, I want to be. I have better qualities, I can be.
That's
right? So Korach wanted to create an election. He didn't like that Moshe appoints, Moshe appoints his brother. Obviously, Moshe did not appoint him by himself. It was Hashem that told him. But Korach had his own reasoning. So, that Korach is paleg. He created a machlekes, created a dispute, strife. Nichlak mishar edo lachzik machlekes. He was different from the rest of the community. And he started a machlekes, started a dispute. Val zeh amu b'mishnah kol machlekes shen shem shem machlekes korach ha'adose. The Mishnah said, you want to know what is a machlekes? What is a dispute that is not for the sake of heaven? It's the machlekes of Korach and his community. Korach and his group. Tzorech lo v'matam lo manikrein yin zeh b'shem machlekes. Why is it called, why the claims of Korach are called machlekes? Ari lo yisuz machlekes gerida lelo tam v'sib. It wasn't just a dispute without reasons. Korach gave his reasonings. Lo yisuz lelo taine al pisechel, he had logical claim. Kamuva b'pirush Rashi. Rashi explains, he had a question about, he had a claim about the appointing Elitzofen, the son of Uzziel, the son of Kehas, the son of Levi. And Moshe Rabbeinu appointed him to be the president on Bnei Kehas. He is the president of Bnei Kehas.
So that's a nice job.
So Korach wanted to jump himself. And he says, Avshar Kotem Mekulam. He says Uzziel was younger than him.
Oh. Yeah.
Thrown under the bus. Avshar Kotem Mekulam. Avshar Kotem Levi. Korach was a Levite.
Yeah.
He was not in the same line with Aaron. Aaron was chesed, he's gevura. Disagreed with him. And therefore, my mom has explained that the machlokes was that he wanted to intensify Gevurah's severities, that they should be the main thing. Gevurah should be the main thing, not Chesed. And this is what is going to happen in time of Mashiach. Gevuris are going to be greater than Chasodim, and it is like it is this way in Atik. In Atik, Gevura is the primary, and Chesed is secondary. In Keser, which Keser is the crown, is above the 10 Sefiros, same way that the Keser is above the head, is a Bechina, is a level of Atik, that is Atik Yemin, the inner level of Keter. It's separated from Yemin, from revelation, from time, from Yom is the revelation light. So Atik Yemin, it's above revelation. But even Atik itself has some kind of an image, has a structure. A structure of we call it in Chassidus, it's called Parzuf. So there's an image of 10 spheres in Atik. But there's a different meaning to that in Atik than, say, the Ishtalshilus. Comes to, say, the Ishtalshilus, comes to Atzilus. The Seder Shtalshilus are now in a state of Gilui. So when it comes to the worlds of Atzilus, emanation, Bria, creation, Yetzirah, formation, and Asiya, action, Gevura is Midas Sadin. Gevura is the attribute of judgment. But Gevura of Atik is a different type of Gevura. It's not necessarily judgment. It's not necessarily severities. Or stern severities. Rather, when it comes to Atik, it's called Gevuras Memutakis. That's what it means, because the structure of Atik is different than the structure of Abiyah, of the lower worlds. So there, the Gevura also exists, but Gevura is Memutakis. It's a sweet Gevuras. The Rebbe explains it in the Kutotero in Shmini Atzeres. The Maimon and Shmini Atzeres speaks about the 13 attributes of mercy. It says, "Vezorakti alech maim teirim." I'm going to, with time of Mashiach, prophecy is that Hashem was going to pour over us pure water. And it says, "What is pure water? What is Vezorakti alechem? I'll pour over you is Gevura Datik Yemin." So Gevura Vatik, which we just said before. It's the sweet gevuras, sweet severities, or you call it sweet judgment, even though in Atik it's not considered a judgment. Why is it called Maim Tahirim? So Akti Olecha Maim Tahirim. Because through them, Tahara is accomplished. So where's Tahara coming? It's coming from Gevura. Purity is coming from Gevura. But it's not Gevura of Atzilus, it's rather Gevura that comes from Atik. Anyway, so this is just like a close quote about this whole thing. Gevura is b'shorash m'mal m'chasodim. Gevura is in the roots are higher than Chasodim. So Korach said, I want to emphasize Gevura because that's how it is in the source. Gevuras are higher than Chasodim. He was Gevura, and Aaron was Chesed. When it comes to revelation, the way it is revealed, Chesed is before Gevura. The way it is expressed, Chesed is before Gevura. The Lossed Lavoi, we are going to see things how they are. Things are going to be revealed the way they are in the root and the source. And in the source, in Atik, Gevura is before Chesed, is the primary thing. So the Taina of Korach, the you can say the claim of Korach, or the demand of Korach has a logical sense not only according to legal, but also according to Chassidus. And it could be justified. It wasn't, we said before, Mishnah tells us, any machlekes that is not for the Shem Shemayim, for the sake of heaven, is machlekes of Korach. So why he has a taina, he has a valid reason to debate the appointing of a litzafon or the appointing of Aaron. Okay, and shall taino, it says since he had the taino, shall be seichel, it's logical demand, a logical claim. It's not just he was trying to find machlekes against Moshe and Aaron to argue with them. So why are you calling it machlekes? If he has a taina, it's not machlekes. If you say something and I tell you something exactly the opposite, but I back it up with reasons, with common sense, I'm not trying to argue with them. I say it differently.
Right.
Why are we calling it machlekes?
Like a face mask issue.
Yeah, so if you come up, okay, face mask. So if you come up, if you bring 100 doctors and saying the face mask is harming to you, and they back it up with research and fact.
Real stuff.
And then there's another 100 doctors who say exactly the opposite, and they back it up with their evidence.
Right.
So it's a machlekes, so it's a debate. It's a real debate,
right?
With real claims,
right?
So Beis, look at Beis. Yuvon be'agdim abiu maimer Mishnah says in Pirkei Avos kol machlekes shel Shem Shamayim sefer liskayim. Any machlekes is Shem Shamayim. Any debate that is really for the sake of heaven, it's something that's going to endure. Okay, Sefer Liskayim. Ezim machlekes shel Shem Shamayim, machlekes Hillel v'Shammai. What is machlekes Shem Shamayim? It's Hillel v'Shammai. Big Shomaral, lama nokat machlekes Hillel v'Shammai, Hillel v'Shammai davka. Maral wrote a book on Pirkei Avos. It's called Derech Chaim. So he asked over there in Derech Chaim, why did he mention machlekes? There's no other machlekes. What about Abai and Rava?
Yeah.
What about Reish Lakish and Rabbi Yochanan?
Right.
There's plenty of machlekes.
Yeah, but we all know Reish Lakish. They love each other. We
know that. So, no, we're saying why specifically they chose machlekes Hillel and Shammai. Ariyesh Kamva Kam machlekes Tanoim. There's many machlekes of other Tanoim. Ve'ilu Ve'ilu Divrei Elokim Chaim. It says that both of them are godly words. I mean, they're not just saying, it's not machlekes, it's like, their opinion is their opinion. That's how they perceive it. They have a source in Kedusha, which is the will and wisdom of God. Obviously, they're all for the sake of heaven. We see it also at the end of the Mishnah. It says, what is the machlokes? It's not for the sake of heaven. It's only the machlokes of Korach. It doesn't mention any other machlokes.
Yeah.
Einu shirak machlokes Korach ein al Hashem Shomayim. Only the machlokes of Korach is not. But machlokes of kol ha-tanayim ha-meiroyim, when it comes to all the machlokes of tanayim ha-meiroyim, like I said, Abayim Rava, all different examples of machlokes of tanayim, it's Hashem Shomayim. Because it's only appointing of Korach. It's not Lashem Shomayim. Imken Zevul Iskayim. So therefore, all the other machlekes. So we still have to understand why specifically the Tana of the Mishnah mentions the machlekes of Hillel and Shammai.
And they were friends too.
We asked a question also about why are you calling Korach machlekes? Why are you calling it machlekes? If he backed it up with real demands and real explanations of why he wants to change things around. He said, "Kulam kedoshim." It's true. What? All the other Jews are not holy. Every Jew has a godly neshama. So why are you picking up Aaron? Why are you picking up a litzofon? צריך להבין, בדברי המשנה שמחלקת שמשון שמיים כמחלקת ירושלמי ספר עסקאי. There's a machlokes for the sake of heaven, sefer iskayim. It's something that's going to last, to endure. Din do pirush kavon beze. What does it mean? Shelo sidlo v'tialoch kevis shamay. The time of Mashiach, halacha would follow be shamay, not be sila. Although now halacha is like be sila, but when it, you mean sefer iskayim, time of Mashiach. So the two opinions will have grounds, will last.
But it lasts.
Two opinions.
You know every year we read Korach, and we talk about it. So it's lasted as long as the other ones.
But what does it mean that Sefer Iskayim? Doesn't mean Sefer Iskayim that you will talk about the machlekes. If you're talking about Korach derogatory in a derogatory way, how does that help Korach?
And in the end, we say he's in the pit saying Torah Emes Moshe Emes.
Right. Sefer Iskayim means that it's halacha will be like him.
It won't be like him. We know that. Okay.
But what will be? Is according to Chassidus, the Gevuras are going to be dominating Chassodim. The Gevuras, as we just said before, the severities of Atik will be revealed,
right,
which is really sweet severities.
Right.
And it says that that's going to happen in time of Mashiach. So according to this, Korach just wanted to create Mashiach time before it was the time.
So he's a tzaddik.
Maybe that would explain why they gave the parsha the name Korach.
Yeah.
It says this Torah would never be replaced. Right? That's the 13 principles of faith.
Right.
That the Rambam writes, the Torah will never be replaced.
Right.
Now, Allah is like Bisilel. Bisil Eina Mishnah. It says, if you have an opinion of a Chama in a place where Bisil are not commenting, it's not a Mishnah. Meaning it's a Deo, it's an opinion that you shouldn't be considering. Nevertheless, it says, Lo Asid Lo V'ti Halacha Kevis Shamay. Time of Mashiach, Halacha will be like Bis Shamay. It's written in Mikdash Melech, in the Zohar, and it says in the Kutetera and a few places. V'she'ein din, l'fishe beis din, lo asid lovi godius min arishoinim v'chochmo v'minyan. It says the beis din of in the time of Mashiach will be greater than the original dayanim, the original judges, be greater in wisdom and in number also, v'minyan. She'ochol levat l'div arishon, be able to change different psaks that were given by the rishoinim. By the first judges, they're going to rule the halacha like Beit Shammai. Chadain tzoch lo'ovin shar mashmos haloshen sefer iskayim shiskayim ha'deriz yachdu. What is sefer iskayim? That both opinion will work together. Iskayim ha'deriz yachdu, even though it's contradicting opinions. L'chir o'ma nafshach. Kivan shuz ma'az aloch kibisil levad. Right now, aloch is like bisil. V'ilosid lov in time of Mashiach, the aloch kibis shamay levad. Aloch will follow only b'shamay. Im ken, emos is kamushne. How can they both work together? It's either aloch like b'shamay, aloch like bisil. You say now aloch is like bisil. We're following bisil now. In time of Mashiach will follow b'shamay. So when is it going to be the time that we follow both of them at the same time? How is it even possible? Another question. Said if you have machlokes, that it's for the sake of heaven, it's going to last, it's going to endure. What does it mean? Shegam lo asid lo v'kashis v'chatum avi minoritziv in the time of Mashiach. As the prophecy of Zechariah says, that in the time of Mashiach, Hashem is going to remove the spirit of impurity from the land. Yishor inyan shel machlokes. The kinds of machlokes is going to remain. That you have one opinion, I can have a different opinion. Shemizem mashu. So spirit of impurity is going to be removed. Machlokes is going to be remain. Okay. So ve'inu move on. My love is there. What's so special that machlokes is going to be is going to remain even in the time of Mashiach? Why do we need machlokes to remain? Isn't it better not to have machlokes? Everyone agreeing? Question mark. Why is there a question mark? Another question. Above our base, the second part of the Mishnah. Machlokes is not for the sake of heaven. It's the machlekes of Korach v'chol hados shemashmous haloshein shekol inyan machlekes shebechreach shiyu shnei tzedodim ein olam shem shumayim. It says the whole concept of machlekes, you have two sides. It says it was not for the sake of heaven. Ve'inu muvan. It's not understood. Shari gam mitzad Korach v'hadosei oyer shelo l'shem shumayim mitzad Moshe v'Aharon hari kavonos l'shem shumayim. Usually when you say it's not Hashem Shemayim, I mean both parties are wrong. Both parties are not doing it Hashem Shemayim, but how can we say it? On the other side was Moshe and Aaron. It's Korach on one side and Moshe and Aaron on the other side. It was direct question on Moshe's ability to appoint the right people for the job.
Right.
And specifically giving his brother the job of being the Kohen Gadol.
Right. But that happened even from the time of the Snah.
So Elitzophon kicked the... because of the appointing of Elitzophon.
Yeah.
Caused Korach to say, that's it. And now he went... So when he went for the job, he went already against the job of the Kohen Gadol. But what really bothered them was the Elitzophon's appointing. And so the Tzofan appointing, that was the last straw on the back of the camel, right? The last straw. But so when he's in Machlokes already, he's arguing about the appointing of Aaron already. He says, why is he a Kohen Gadol? I want to be a Kohen Gadol. But he said it in a different way, because how can he gather 250 the heads of the Sanhedrin, the head of the court, with him, if not, if he's going to say, I want to be a Kohen Gadol. You see, you want to be a Kohen Gadol, go fight for it yourself. What do you want from us? So he told him, you're all holy, everyone should, and but in the meantime, he was his personal thing. And he wanted to become somebody. He was somebody way before. There was no one wealthier like him.
He was very smart, too.
And he was a tzaddik. He carried the oven for 6 months. The Midrash says he carried the ark. Imagine, someone who carries the ark and has the machsheves psul and he has a different thought, not in place. He dies on the spot, and Korach survived all this. Meaning he was on a higher level. It's not talking about some nobody that says, "I want to be a." Right. We have to get to the root of the machlekes. The debate of Korach. Shalzenem of Veikach. Vetirgem Unkelus is Paleg. Shadiuk is Paleg Davka. Unkelus translates Veikach Korach is Paleg. He created Pilug. Pilug is creating a split. Okay?
Yeah.
Wow. So here it says that we can say that the Megal HaMukis, he says it in the name of Rabbeinu Bechaye, Rabbeinu Bachi, he says that the community of Korach were reincarnation for the generation of the disbursement. Okay? Remember those who wanted to build a
tower, right.
And they said, we're going to fight Hashem.
Yeah.
And then what happened? Hashem dispersed them. He created Pilug. Yeah. They are Palgo because Pilug was created. They're dispersed all over the place.
Because they got along with each other.
Right. So is Palag Miloshan Apalgo. So that's where Unkelus takes the Losh and the expression Vis Palag, created a split, Miloshan Apalgo, from the same as the generation of the Apalgo, the generation of the dispersement. Kibiyom of Niflagoritz, why they were called the generation of the Palgo, of the dispersement, because in their times the land was dispersed. Because it was Sofo Achas Dvorim Acholim. It was one language, one word, they're all speaking the same language. And after the situation with the tower that they built, the punishment was that they were scattered. And each one had different languages, and things were changed from that point on. Zeo Gamashikosu. The person calls them Dera Pago and Shishem. Hashem Shomu Beis Dera Pago. He said, what was their mission statement? What they wanted to accomplish? Nivne Lonu Ir, will build a city for ourselves. Umigdal, in a tower, and its head is in the heaven. Venasel Lonu Shem. What does it mean? Venasel Lonu Shem, and we'll build ourselves. We'll make ourselves a name. What type of branding they wanted to do? So it says, and shame. What they really are trying to do is idolatry. So it says in Bereishis Rabo Perek Lamed Ches, over there it says in Pasuk Ches, what shame they wanted to accomplish, Dera Palgo, they want to create idolatry. It says there's another aspect to the Machlekes of Korach that even preceded the generation of the disbursement. We now associated Korach with Dera Palgo because of the translation of Unkelus, Spaleg, Dera Palgo. Over there they also had Machlekes, and Machlekes with Hashem. Says, "Kaidua the Mashakosu veis paleg oderech hakia mavde b'mayin l'mayin." It says in the Torah regarding the creation of the world, it says, "Vayase lekim esarkia." Hashem created the firmament, vayavde b'namayim, and created a separation between the lower water and the upper water.
Right.
The water that below the firmament, and the water that are above the firmament. Shizoi. This is the separation between the upper and lower water. That's the first machlekes, the first division that we saw in the Torah. And right away, in the second day of creation already, Hashem created the Rakiyah, Mavdil B'mayin L'mayin, in division between upper water and lower. Why are we creating a division? They were all together. Suddenly you're creating a division. So that's the root for any machlekes, the division of the upper water and the lower water. It says in the Midrash, in Bereishis Rabo, Lama ein kesiv basheni kitoiv. Why doesn't it say on the second day, the day that Hashem created the division between the upper and lower water, it doesn't say vayar lekim kitoiv. Hashem saw that it was good. All the other days of creation, it says Kitoiv. On Monday, it doesn't say Kitoiv.
Right.
Why? It says Sheboi Nivra Machlokes, because Machlokes was created on the second day.
Because the
upper and lower water. So how can you call... No, but that's the root of all the other Machlokes. That's the problem. So it tells you, it's not like a one-time incident. That's the creation of Machlokes. Shenemar v'imavdi b'mayim lo moim, v'ayim b'zeh sh'ayishalkos b'mayim lo moim, v'asheresh, that's the root for chet etzadas, the root for the sin of the tree of knowledge, V'deira palgo, and then the generation of the disbursement. V'ad l'machlekes koach v'adose, ultimately coming all the way down to the dispute of Korach and his community.
We should learn more now.
Ubi roi, yedin ubusinu zav, Rabbi said, this was also in Bereish Yisrabo Mitchil, as B'yosa Shaloylom, the beginning of creation of the world, initially at creation, it says all the waters were connected together. Beginning, there was no division between the upper water and the lower water. Through the separating firmament, there was no such division. Lo yokilus shel HaKadosh Baruch Hu oil ela min ha-mayim. The praising of God would only come through water. Moshe le-melech, and it brings an analogy to this. Moshe le-melech shebono paltrin, an example of a king that built a palace. Ve'oishi b'seicho ilmi, and he placed in the palace, inhabited the palace with people that are mute. Bunch of people that are mute.
At least you don't have to worry about them arguing.
They would wake up and ask about the well-being of the king with their fingers trying to communicate. Bilmizo, they couldn't say it. So the Midrash says, when Hashem said, Vayemer Elokim ikovu amayim, we said it says in Tilmin Garos Chenusin Mikol, Obikia Beshem Rabbi Ami, Beshem Rabbi Abi Barami Omar Yase Midolamayim, Ich Madazon Vekavi Noterushan, Biaba Kan Beshem Rabbi Omar Kadishboch, Omar Kadishboch, Hashem said, Ikovuli Amayim, Mashani Osid Lassis Boim. Oh, so it says Hashem looked at the remember the analogy of this mute people in the palace. The king looks at them and he says, wow, they're trying to ask for my well-being. Imagine they weren't mute. How much more so they would be discussing the well-being of the king.
Yeah.
How much more so they would be praising the king. It's like same thing with the water. It's like if the water now are occupied with kilusay, with praising Hashem, how much more so there will be when there will be upper water and lower water. So what did the king do in the mashal? The Midrash says, so he put pikhim, he put wise people in the. What did the wise people do? He said, this is not the palace of the king. See, the smart ones. This is not the palace of the king. So the king said, you know what? Let's go back to the original. To the original. Let's put the mute people back. So similarly, with the creation of the world, Hashem's praise would come from the water. That's what we say, Mikoylo Yismayim Rabim Adirim, said in the davening of Shabbos. Mikoylo Yismayim Rabim Adirim Mishper Yom. What praise is to say, Adir Bamorim Hashem. Hashem is great. Hashem is great in the heavens. Omar Kishbohu, Ma Elu Shein Lam Leipev Lamir Vladibu. Says this water, they don't have a mouth to speak. They can't say anything, and they are praising me. When I will create men, after the Mabul, when I create men, they will for sure praise me. Comes the generation of the Mabul, the generation of the flood, and rebelled against Hashem. They didn't praise Hashem. Comes the generation of Enosh, and rebelled against Hashem. Comes the generations of the disbursement, and rebelled against Hashem. So Hashem says, you know what, let's put the water back. And that's what happened. That's the Mabul. That's the pasuk. Vayageshem al olot sabayim v'amorot. The rain came 40 days and 40 nights. So that's because of all this generation. Come one generation after the other and rebelled against Hashem. And the whole idea was, Hashem said, look, the water are praising me as is. They don't have a mouth. What's going to happen when I'll bring someone that can praise me? Hashem brought human beings and instead they rebelled against God. So He said, you know what, let's put the water back. It's the same analogy with the king that had deaf-mute people in the palace, and they were praising him, Bermiza, and hinting. Once they were, Hashem said, you know what's going to happen when I bring wise people? He brought the wise people, and instead they said, it's not his palace. Yeah. Who is he? Who does he think he is? He said, you know what, let's put the mute people back. Same thing over here. It says, before the creation of the world, when all the waters were mixed together, praising Hashem, Hashem said, you know what, let me make a separation. Create a room, create a space for human beings to live in the world. Brought them down, and they said, who are you? He said, that's why the Mabul came to the world. He said, let's go back to the original. It doesn't work out.
Yeah. And then he brought
up,
then he had Noach, and then he started the whole thing all over again.
Line 4, Shediyurim, Ilmim, Shoyim, Kalsim, Bermizah, currently, we're having a discussion between them. What does it mean that inhabitants that are deaf mute is referring to the creatures that are in the concealed world, the fish, always going like this.
You are in the.
Although it's beautiful, it's great, the praising of those who are deaf mute, when the world was full with water, the whole world was alma diskasa, the whole world was a world of concealment. And no one rebelled against Hashem. Nevertheless, Hashem created a separation between mine, between water to water. Through a firmament that separates. Say, why Abasho? And then the Abasho was visible. Shu'inyan, line 11, Almodis Galia. Shanivroim Shuboy, Hem Bevchinas Matsius Yesh Davko. Then you have the Abasha, the dry land, and the created beings that are living in dry land are not nullified to the source of their life, to their neshama, to Hashem. They are metzius. Yes, davka. Chena kavana shanivoyim yishovchem metzius. Hashem created us in one way, but the kavana is that we should not remain that way. What is the ultimate purpose? That the existence of the yesh itself, so I'm existing, but the existence, the kli that you have will become a vessel for godliness. Ultimately, godly revelation will come into created beings even though they are yesh. Reconciliation or the rectification for separation and division. Although on the second day, it doesn't say kitov on the second day. Why? Because the day created machlekes. It says on the third day, kitov shnepom. It says kitov twice. Echod lemelechas ha'mayim, one for Monday, for the melechas ha'mayim is what was done with the water, and one for the creation of Tuesday. So why doesn't it say toiv on the second day? Because the work with the water was completed on Tuesday. Start on Monday. But it was completed only on Tuesday. So something that is not complete, you don't say yet Kitoiv. But on Tuesday, he said twice Kitoiv. One for Monday and one for Tuesday. שעל ידי ההבדולו והמחלקס נזהין של האחדוס איסקלוס ופינליס, through ההבדולו, through separation, through מחלקס, sometimes it leads afterward to a greater unity. It happened because after Korach, after his מחלקס, Jewish people are united around Moshe now and more than ever because they saw that this is the real thing.
But right after it, when they went into the hall, the Jewish people got all excited and they were fighting Hashem, and he brought a plague, and then they had to have the whole thing with the sticks and the almonds. So,
what?
So, it didn't happen like that. Look at this. Hashem got rid of the bad guys, and we should be happy. They didn't go like that.
Right.
Just saying.
Yeah.
I mean, it's right in the
portion.
I'm not saying anything that's not there.
No, but in general, Hashem created so-called independent, separated beings.
Yeah.
But the objective is that it should create, even though they're, like I just said before, that they'll become a vessel for godliness, create even a greater unity than existed before. Shemitzius Hayesh Gufa. That the existence of the Yesh itself will become a vessel for godliness. Now we're going to Chof Zayin. This concept was revealed in Matan Torah. At that time, the decree was completely annulled between the upper and the lower, that the lower ones would ascend to the upper ones, and the upper ones will come down. That's the bond between spirituality and physicality. We can create this bond through Torah mitzvahs, because all the mitzvahs that they are the will of God were enclosed in physical things like tzitzis, in physical wool, tefillin, physical cloth. Valadei kiyum mitzvahs nasa dovar gash mikliligus. So you do a mitzvah, the physical object becomes a vessel for godliness. Uchmo yichen belimud atero shamech hagashmi shelodim misachdim atero sholemet. Deze misachdim ulikus. When it comes to learning Torah, your mind becomes one with aspect of godliness. You become one with the Torah, and you become one with the Likus, physical brain, your mech, your intellect. Zo shatir nitno lemata davka. That's why the Torah was specifically given lemata. In this world, Kamara was saying Uzal, it says in the Gemara, in Shabbos, 88, that Moshe Rabbeinu says to the angels when they said, no, it's chol shamayim, leave it here, wanted Hashem to give them the Torah. And Moshe said to him, Mitzrayim yoratim, etz ha'orash b'neichem, did you go down to Mitzrayim? Do you have an evil inclination? Why do you need the Torah? The Torah was specifically given to us. Rabbi Seinu Zal, the rabbi said, the whole Torah was given to create peace in the world. That's the bond between creator and the created. That the world will be a dwelling place for Hashem. This is the words of the Midrash, and it's explained in many places in Chassidus. At length, that the purpose of the creation is to create a Dirat Hashem, a place that is worthy of godly revelation, worthy of the residing of the divine presence, specifically in this physical world. This is also the union of Machlekes Hashem Shomayim. The union of Hashem Shomayim, Beisus Akabolo, Uyichud Zeran Pemachus. What does it mean, Shem Shomayim, for the sake of heaven? says in the letters of Kabbalah, in Chassidus, it's the yichud between Zeranpin and Malchus. The unity between the Midas and sovereignty and Malchus. A flow of godliness, of godly light that comes through a unity between the supernal Midas, Chesed, Gevurah, and On, a small face, with Malchus, Sfiras HaMalchus. Ki Shomayim b'chinas Zeranpin. Shomayim is connected with the supernal Midas, Zeranpin, the small face. The Midas v'Sheim b'chinas Malchus. So Shomayim is Zeranpin, and Sheim is Malchus. What is the objective of Malchus? To reveal and to bring down the light of the light, the energy that comes from the higher spheres. V'inyon b'aveido, how do you create this chibur, this unity of Zeranpin and Malchus? How can we create this bond? Before Baruch Shomo, you say the Shem Yichud Kutshu Baruchu Shri. Right. Shem Yichud creating a Yichud. I want to create a union. So, Vinyan Ba'Avedo comes to Avedas Hashem. Uchi Baruch Nisim Gashmus, connecting spirituality with physicality. Ki Shomayim Me'el Yeruchnius. V'Shem Me'el Yeruchnius. Shomayim representing spirituality. Shem representing this world. A name represents this world. Heaven, Shomayim, represents spirituality. Kishem, Wero, Bilvad, Vilet. Shem is just a ray, not the essence. Same way that your name is not your essence. Ozel, Bussin, Uzal, Rabbi said in Koheles Rabbo, Midrash, Olach, HaKadosh Baruch Hu, Malach, Tav Kuf Shon, Likunos Shem. It says Hashem went 500 years to acquire a name for himself. This is the distance from the heaven to the firmament. That's the Gemara in Chagiga 13a. It says the difference between heaven to the firmament is 500 years. So the earth to Akia, so from the firmament to the earth, is 500 years. So concept of shame is connected, acquiring a name is connected with the descent from above, from spirituality, from Rakia, from heavens, to Lamato, to Gashmi, to a place of physicality, to the earth. Going to Chaf Ches. V'zeh inyan machlekes l'shem shomayim. This is the meaning of debate, controversy, that is for the sake of heaven. Shekavonos ha-machlekes ha-avdolo. What is the kavanah? What is the intent of the division? Of the split. Create a bond between spirituality and physicality. Shomayim and Eretz. Right? Shegam Agashmius Tia Klila Likus. That even physical things will be, even things that are separated, will be a vessel for godliness. What does it mean that argument for the sake of heaven is going to last, going to endure? Shelavaseftiskayim kavonas ha-machlokes. The reason for the machlokes is going to be fulfilled at the end. Lo'ovili de'achdus v'iskalus, which will bring about unity and oneness and wholesomeness. Be'efen na'le yeser, in a much greater way. Shegam agash mishchab mo'uchus ha-likus. Not only that spirituality will connect with Gashmius, but it will be the other way around, that Gashmius will go back and connect itself with spirituality and godliness. Okay, so we'll stop here. We'll continue, God willing, tomorrow.
So I read the whole book on...